it was fairly normal practice when you finish your PhD to try to go, in those days, to go to America. Princeton was an obvious place for me because of the Kodaira and Spencer were in Princeton, and the Institute for Advanced Study had all these visitors. And so Hodge had been himself a year in Princeton way back in the 30s. At Lefschetz was at Princeton University. So Hodge was well. So he actually went to a conference in Princeton around about 53, 54, and talked to Kodaira Spencer and showed them the work that I was doing at that stage, which they were interested in. So more or less Spencer said, you know, come over. And so when I finished, I applied for a Commonwealth Fellowship, which I got, and that paid for me to go. If I hadn't got that, I might have got help by Princeton University. And then Spencer said, well, don't come to the university, go to the Institute, because the Institute has better facilities for visitors. And so he suggested I apply to the Institute. So I went there. But I mean, at that time, there were opportunities for people to go much more limited than they are now. And very few places you could go so easily as the Institute. So there was a big concentration of visitors to the Institute. And also, it was a kind of post-war period. A lot of people's careers had been upset by the war, so there's a kind of whole concentration of several generations, you know, overlapping together. So when I went to the Institute in Princeton, there was a galaxy of talent, the people that I met. Bott was there, and Sayre was there, Hitzelberg was in the university, Singer came. So the whole range of people, many of them older than me, all arriving at the same time and spending years at the Institute. So it was very... And then we had the older people, Spencer and Kodaira, in the university, and Lefschetz was still there. Herman Weyler just died before I arrived, which I was really, as had Einstein. Yeah. It was obviously the right place to go at that time, enormously beneficial in terms of opening up your outlook. I mean, Cambridge was was reasonable, with Hodge and people, but we didn't have many of the kind of visitors you get streaming through nowadays. Yeah. You kept in touch by looking at the journals as they appeared, and you corresponded with people internationally. Much weaker now, we didn't have email. For example, I got my fellowship in Trinity end of my second year of research. And my work on sort of vector bundles, and also the work on integral of the second kind, which I did with Hodge simultaneously. My third year, I think here was probably a sort of kind of fallow year, really, because my research had sort of come to a natural end. I wasn't quite sure where to go. There was nothing more I could get from the environment around me. You know, we still were seminars and so on, but And I don't think the third year he was terribly profitable in some sense. I enjoyed being a fellow of the college and all that sort of thing. And I learned out, I learned a few things, but it wasn't... But when I went to Princeton, it was totally different. I went to lectures, Bott gave lectures on Morse theory and Lie groups, and Kodaira was giving lectures on sheaf theory and algebraic geometry, and Spencer and Sayre was giving a seminar on this and that. So in a very short period of time, I was exposed to a whole range of new things. I didn't know much about Lie groups before. I picked that up a bit from Bott, and I learned a lot from Sayre. And I had direct contact with him and with Hitzelberg with characteristic classes. So, the opportunity was enormous, and I just certainly didn't have that in Cambridge. So that year, I spent a year and a half in Princeton. Mm. I learnt a whole lot of new ideas, pushed in new directions a bit. Came back with lots of things to work on, and also made contact with all these people whom I subsequently saw much more of over the years to come. So it was tremendous impact on my whole career, really. It was at the right stage. I mean, although I could have gone a year earlier and also benefited, probably.